afternoon. I'm on the airplane. It's not powered. First thing I'm going to do is go down here in the E&E area and connect the main battery. This is where we keep a lot of our electronics. Not all of them. This is the main battery, that green thing. What I'm going to do is connect that. You twist that on. Now the main battery is connected. And because of our interior, if we leave our main battery connected, it will drain. So I'll reset the battery charger circuit breaker. Come over here and reset the other main battery charger circuit breaker, crew rest container, and the fire bottles. So it looks like down here when it's night. It's not actually night, it's dark down here. All right, now we'll go up and start the APU. All right, I'm in the cockpit. Get ready for a flight. And the first thing I'm gonna do after we've connected the main battery is I'm gonna turn on the main battery. And then I'm gonna start the APU. You go over to the start position and then it's spring loaded back to the on. And that starts the start sequence. Fault light means the door is opened. Now I'm going to also turn on the main battery, or turn on the emergency lights. So those are armed. Just by closing that switch, it moves from off. This wire down here pulls it into the armed position. You can see that the lights, emergency lights came on. Now as soon as we get main power, emergency lights will go out and they'll charge them, go into a maintenance mode where they charge up and they just stay in their armed state ready to be used in case there is an emergency. I can hear the APU spooling up. We should get power here any second. Okay, we'll turn on the adrias, window heats. We'll turn on the nav light. We're gonna open, well, we'll wait on the outflow valves. The fire detection system come on line, green light there, and then the other one right above it will come on another one for the different zones in the cabin. Thank you. the airplane's up and running. What I want to do now is I'm going to start checking the systems. So I select, this is my control panel, and I can select these different display units. So this is the center one here, the left inboard there, or the right inboard here. Oh, center lower. That's this one down there. Okay, so what I want to do is I'm on the right inboard one. I want to display my current status so I can check how things are doing. Okay, so the fuel shutoff valve battery is not, it needs attention is what that's indicating, the message. So what I'm going to do is we always disconnect that battery during parking times and then reconnect it. All right, now the message is cleared. And this is where you want it to look when you do a pre-flight. You don't want to have any messages because that means you don't have any problems indicated by the data bus of the airplane. So the airplane has done all of its checks and says it's ready to go. Now what I'm going to do a fire test. So I'll push the fire test button here. This is our fire control panel. This is the fire control panel. What I'm going to do is push this here. That's our fire overheat test. And it'll run a test, and you'll see it show up there. All right, test passed. All right, I want to check the engine oils. Got a good quantity of the engine oil. This is our APU. Got good quantity on the hydraulic fluids. And the crew oxygen, I'll need to turn that on yet. Okay, I'm back down. I'm going to turn the crew oxygen bottle on. It's under the, near the landing gear, near the nose wheel landing gear. All right, we need to have some water service, so I got to call our handling agent to bring a water truck over. It's their frequency. I'll set up my panel here. I'm on the center radio. Use that microphone. Airbasco, November 777 Alpha Sierra. Yeah, so we'd like to have a water service, please. Thank you. All right, so the water service is requested. Yep. Yep.
Okay.
Windows are filthy. Gotta clean those.